Okay, that's good. So, let's go over something. You have this lecture syllabi. I'll just briefly talk about this. So the lecture is completely online. And you're pretty much sure I already put like 3 modules there. That is one slide, one section of the slides, then I put in 3 modules, so you go ahead to rock. And I hope it's good. Now the only thing there is something will be stopped in the middle because the pen what I'm writing is an electronic pen. Sometimes it's not very comfortable. So it has to be off, then on again. Okay, so there's some block there. But you just watch the module. Now, I don't have any of the homework. You don't have to worry about all these dates. I just put it there because it's required. Basically, I will put modules onto the eCampus every week, about like 3. Then the only time we're not gonna change is the exam time. Now what I'm going to do is that, ideally, if we finish this semester, the lab is in person, like what we did right now. What I can simply do is, for example, September 15th, I can just give you the exam paper. Then you go home to do, and about 1 week, you return all your exam paper to me. It's completely open book. You do whatever you like, as long as you put a good answer there. Okay, so that's very simple and easy. Now, if university is put everything online in case something happens, let's say October 1st, we say everybody go home and we gonna completely teach online, then the question I will be move them onto eCampus and I will send another email around it. Okay, if everything is good, we will do the paper. I just give it to you, give it back to me because it's easy. Okay, so that's what we talk about the lecture. Another thing I want to mention is that something we are talking in the lab, we also maybe show in the lecture slides, so I will talk a little bit more detail. So for example, when we talk about microscope use, I will talk a little bit about dark field microscope, because we do use light bright field microscope, we are going to talk dark field a little bit. And when we move on to later on the biochemistry section, there's a certain time we will talk about how to calculate 38 ATPs through aerobic respiration, and I'll draw here. So I will not talk too much on the module in the video, but I'll draw here, then you will know it clearly. So some of the lecture material, if the lab is covered, I will talk a little bit more. So basically, the lab is the first 30 minutes, I will give presentation, which is like a lecture, then you do the other hour. Okay, so that's how we're gonna do. So lecture is completely online. Now, another thing I wanna also mention is, this class is lecture and the lab are combined. So you basically have to do a good of lecture and also the lab section, not the separate, okay? Although you have a separate sections. So this is something briefly for the lecture. Now I'm going to talk about the lab. So you should have the syllabi, which is start from the August 27. So I'm going to write here. August 27, that is our first lab. Okay, following will be, we meet once every week. Therefore, you will be only meet here. So that's you always time is Tuesday 12, 30 to 1:45. That is your time. We only gonna meet here. Now there's something I want to mention. Because we meet once every week, so some of your lab results will not be very good because it's too long. It's used to be we meet twice every week, okay? So that's something I wanna make. This is your time, you just write on your notebook. Lab attendance. lab attendance basically is required. I will say basically is required. If you have anything bad happens, then you don't come in. But in this semester, I'm probably not going to take your attendance check. But make sure your seat is the same. You stay on your same seats the whole semester, because otherwise we have to fill another report. Okay, that's. But basically, it's required because you know what we are doing here. You get the practice. That is lab attendance is required, and the lab video. I will be upload each Wednesday onto eCampus. So if you miss one section, you can go to watch. Now for all the lab practice, I will make a video ahead of time. So for example, when you guys go home, Lee will work with me. We will do the videotaping of my doing the microscope use. And then next week when you go home, I'll do the simple stem, then I'll upload onto the eCamp so you look at that first. The reason is, before the normal time, I can just show you guys today, I'll say everybody come here, then I'll do the gram stem, I'll do simple stem. Now we cannot do that. So I do that ahead of time and upload the video onto the eCampus. So you can go ahead to watch first what we are doing, okay? So that's something I want to mention. Now, regarding the safety, the very important thing here is wash hands. So what you should do, before you come here, you have to wash hands. And then you wear your gloves. Now where you get gloves, you can get one box at CVS, Walgreens, or any of the drugstore. Okay, wear gloves. Then, you do your work. Now very important, wear goggles when we do any of the stand. Because the dye will hurts your eye. Okay, so wear goggles. Then everything finished. You have to clean your bench. Basically, we say sanitize it. And then you wash your hands again before you leave here. And the gloves go to biohazard trash can. Not regular trash can, the bell has the trash can. Okay, right there, the bell has the trash can. That is something important. Now, lab coat. If you have your lab coat for other classes, please bring. If you have your old coat, as long as it can cover, if you have a long coat, as long as it's covered the knee, you can bring here. Okay, you don't have to wear a professional medical lab coat. If you have any old coat can cover your knee, you can bring here. And also you can buy a lab coat just online. It's very simple. You know how to purchase anything online, is that right? You can buy a lab coat. That's pretty, maybe $30, $50. And you can use the rest of your life. I mean, if you, any classes, lab classes, now, one more thing is no open toe shoes. Okay? No open toe shoes. Okay, so these are the things I want to mention in addition to what Amy just said. Okay, so let's look at here what we have the lab work. Now, basically what we have here is a microscope we used at the beginning. Then the simple stem, gram stem, endospore stem, that's a stem technology combined with microscope use. Then we have aseptic technique, which means bacteria transfer, a different type of the media. Then we have a pure culture techniques, enumeration, which is talk about pore plating, spread plating. Then we talk about temperature, oxygen cultivation. Then we have at October, we have like three labs of very intensive, which is we do about biochemistry test. So you see the urea test, the carbohydrates, catalase, hydrogen sulfide, oxidase, those are biochemistry test. Then we have the antibiotic test, microbial counts on the food products in the pond water. Okay, so those pretty much is observation, isolation, enumeration, and the identification of bacteria. We focus on the bacteria. We're not going to do any of the virus here because this is biosafety level one. So there is a four level, biosafety level one, like we did the generic E. coli is biosafety level one. Biosafety level two, like you have the news about Salmonella or like a pistachio, outbreaks, that is a biosafety level two. Biosafety level three, Clostridium. Clostridium botulinum perfringens, those are biosafety level three. Biosafety level four, COVID-19, those are tuberculosis, those are biosafety level four. So we only do biosafety level one here, which is most of the generic bacteria. Okay, so that's something. Okay, now I'm gonna talk about the exam. We'll have two exams here, which is midterm, October 8th, and the final exam, November 24th. Now, what I'm going to do is that's called a semi-open book exam. Okay, we want to do semi-open book exam. What that means? You can bring your lab notebook, the fact sheets what I give to you. I'll give you fact sheets pretty much very detailed. Before the lab, I'll put it right there, then you grab it. And the class notes. But you can bring the computer and you can talk to each other. Okay, that's why I say the semi-open book. So I give you exam paper. You can look at your own lab notebook. You can look at your lab records or whatever I lectured. You can look at your personal notes, but not gonna bring the computer. You just search online, not chatting with each other, or not the teamwork, which means you do it based on the material which is available to you. Okay, and also the fact sheets in the class, that's okay. Okay. So, but also everybody do by yourself, not gonna talk around. So that's how you say the semi-open book exams. So lecture completely open book and the lab is semi-open book. Now, another thing I also wanna mention, I have some email who is, somebody is sending to me asking about a lab notebook. In this semester, I'm not required to do. Before we required everybody to do, and that's 50 points. 50 points for the lab notebook, because I go to each bench and I grade it individually. But right now I try not to become as close to you too much. So the lab notebook will be a choice. So what we do is that at the end of the semester or some certain of this time, I will say, if you have a lab notebook, please bring and we'll do a checkoff for you. And then we'll give you extra 20 points add up with at the end. Now, I don't think you need that. With all the open book questions and the semi-open book for the lab exam, you should do very well. But in case something happens, so if you planning to do, you prepare a lab notebook. But I encourage you to do because you know what you're doing there. And that's good for your review, okay? Now, if you're planning to do a lab notebook, you follow the instruction on the page three. Which means each lab, you're gonna have introduction, materials, methods, results, and a brief discussion or the implication. And I'll go over the lab results every time when we start a new lab. Okay, so that's something I wanna mention. Okay, so that's all I have. Any questions you have? Yes.
In the email that you sent us, it said to be here like for Thursday, and then all the dates on our folder for Thursday, not Tuesday.
Oh, sorry, it's Thursday. I made a mistake. Sorry. Sorry, I want to correct it here. Thursday. That's a good catch. Okay, Thursday. Okay, right here, yeah.
Is there any sort of homework or is it just the lectures?
I try not to put too much homework. I mean, this semester is a difficult time, and I hope you learn something, but your safety is more important, so I don't put too much homework. The exam is good. Now, every fact sheet, there is two questions, which is take home questions you think about yourself. I may ask you at the beginning of the lab, I'll say, what do you think about that? Okay, but basically you do the home, you do the exam, that should be good. But lab will be pretty intensive because we combine the two labs. So usually we do the microscope, then we do simple stain, then we do gram stain in a separate lab. So you go home very early. People often complain, say your lab is too short sometimes, but this time we'll be completely using at least 1 hour. So you'll get off at least 1:30 if you come here 12:30, okay? So that's, you will be using the whole time. So, yeah. Any other questions? So just one more thing, one more time, okay, emphasize, Thursday, 12:30 to 1:45 right here. Okay, so once every week, okay? Okay, one more thing I forgot. If university is said we go everything online, including lab, I will be spending some time working with Lee. We will be video recording all the lab practice. And I put on the eCampus, you go ahead and look. I may download something from YouTube for some existing video. I don't like to use it as a person because it's very lazy. I just download everything. I can certainly go lab online. I said, everybody go ahead and look at YouTube. I don't want to do that because it's more the material which is in front of us. It's more natural, you know. Otherwise, it's like all the artwork online. So I will be videotape what we are practicing. We put online, and I may add a little bit more homework if it's completely online. But if not, then if it's in classroom, then that should be okay. There are going to be no more homework. Okay, that's good. Yes. Usually what they do is that they do notebook. If I said a lab notebook, that's another book, not another notebook. So let's just have an example. Yeah, so another one, which is you're taking the notes when I talk. So usually students prepare too. But it's up to you. If you wanted to do, let's say you have a folder, you in the front, you wanted to take the lecture notes, or the lab lecture notes, then the back you want to become a lab notebook, that's fine. But I'd suggest you have two. Okay, then. Oh no, you don't have to. Any lab notebook is fine. Any book is fine. But if you want that 20 points, you have to write very clearly. You can just write a couple of sentences and say, oh, this is my lab notebook. I mean, you have to do it very well. And I encourage you to do, because usually the good lab notebook will have a very good grade. Usually that will happen, okay? Now, and I also want to mention, oh, I said it's open book, it's semi-open, you still have to be study a little bit. Because when I said open book, oh, then you don't read anything. You know, when you come here, you're difficult to find the answer. So you still have to read a little bit, but you don't have to remember, which means all the terminologies, all the bacteria names that usually we're required to do, but not this semester, okay? So I hope you learn something, but the most important is keep everybody safe. That's a go, okay? Yeah, any other questions? Okay, so we end off today. So see you next Thursday right here. Okay, when you go home, also you do is that bench by bench. Okay, Lee just opened the door for them. Yeah, bench by bench, not like everybody crushed it. Okay. Sure. Yeah, sure. Okay, in a second. What?
You done with it?
Yeah, I'm done with it. Just kidding. No, that may be.